Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Rohan Khandelwal. I head the Department of Breast Diseases and Cancer Care at C.K. Birla Hospital, Gurgaon. Now, a lot of people ask me, what is the need of having a dedicated breast surgeon or a dedicated breast department? Well, in the last few years in India, the incidence of breast cancer has increased exponentially. The current statistics show that one in every 21 Indian ladies will suffer from this disease during their lifetime. But that's not all. By 2025, it's said that one in eight Indian ladies will suffer from this disease. So as you can see, the numbers are increasing exponentially. So first, let me talk about that. Why is this trend being observed? Why are the numbers rising so quickly? Well, for any cancer, there are risk factors, and the risk factors are both modifiable and non-modifiable. The non-modifiable risk factors are those which we get from our parents in terms of the genetic makeup, and these are factors which are not under our control. These include increasing age, which increases the risk of breast cancer. Period starting early, that's called menarche, when the periods start in a lady. If they start early, that increases the risk of breast cancer. Or if the periods end late, if there's a late menopause. Again, a strong family history of cancer puts the lady at a higher risk of getting breast cancer. The non-modifiable risk factors, as I told you, are not in our control. But the modifiable ones, if we can control them, we can reduce the risk of getting breast cancer by 20 to 30%. And three very simple modifiable risk factors are obesity, so you have to maintain your weight, no smoking, and no alcohol consumption. If these three things are taken care of, you can reduce your risk substantially. In addition to this, breastfeeding is very important. If a lady breastfeeds for 1 year, then the risk of breast cancer goes down. And this is one of the reasons why we are seeing that ladies are at a higher risk and more breast cancer is occurring, because as more and more ladies are joining back work early, they are compromising on the breastfeeding part. Also, they're having their first child at a later age. It's usually after 30 years of age, and that also puts the lady at a higher risk of breast cancer. In addition to all of this, pollution, which we can't quantify unfortunately, also plays a role. Because I get so many ladies whom I treat and they don't have a single risk factor which I mentioned to you, but they still get breast cancer. So of course, the environmental factors also play a role. Now, I've already told you how to reduce your risk of breast cancer, but what is also important is how can we detect it early? Because if we detect it early, there are two distinct advantages. One is that the survival is much, much better, and the lady does not need to remove her entire breast. No need for a mastectomy. You can save the breast. We can do a breast conservation surgery. And the second advantage is that in a select group of patients, chemotherapy can be avoided. And if you talk to any cancer patient, they all will tell you that chemotherapy is the most dreaded part. So these are two distinct advantages of detecting breast cancer early, and that can be done by three methods. By being breast aware, that means by doing regular self-checks or regular self-examinations. By visiting a doctor once a year after 35 years of age for a checkup. Why is this important? Because when you do a self-checkup, you can only pick up lumps which are, say, 2 centimeters or 3 centimeters in size. But a doctor who's regularly examining patients of breast diseases can pick up lumps which are even a centimeter in size, and they can detect cancer much early. In addition to all this, after 40 years of age, please don't forget to get a mammogram done. Now, please remember, that mammographies don't prevent breast cancer, but they help in early detection. And the radiation exposure because of a mammogram cannot induce a breast cancer. So don't be scared because of that. So these are some simple measures which you can adopt to reduce your risk and to detect breast cancer early. Please remember that this is affecting ladies in their 20s, 30s, 40s, all the way up till their 90s. So don't think that if you're young, you're immune to this disease. It's best to be breast aware. And once you get to know about this disease, you should create more awareness by sharing the facts which I've discussed in this video with your friends and family members as well. Thank you.